Vienna, a city of music, culture, and endearing charm.
Since the time of Rizal and Viola's visit, Vienna has experienced the collapse of its empire, two world wars, and national transformation. Yet, at the same time, the Vienna of today may not be so foreign to our heroes, as you will see on our short walk around the town. Lakbayin natin ang siyudad na ito mula sa mga mata ng dalawang Pilipinong propagandista na namasyal dito ng apat na araw, 134 years ago in 1887.
Before he stepped into his critical role in our country's fight for independence, our national hero, Jose Rizal, and his friend Maximo Viola were similar to young, highly educated, and privileged Filipinos nowadays. Parehong graduate ng medisina sila Rizal at Viola sa Espanya. Sinamahan ni Viola si Rizal noong taong 1887 sa Berlin, kung saan inilimbag ang Noli Me Tangere. Matapos ng publikasyon ng nobela, pinalak ni Rizal na bumiyahe sa iba't ibang siyudad sa Europa upang makipagkita sa kanyang matalik na kaibigang Austrian na si Dr. Ferdinand Blumentritt, makilala ang iba't ibang mga intelektual at eksperto at personal na masilayan at maranasan ang kultura ng iba pang bahagi ng Old World. Sumama sa kanya sa biyaheng ito si Viola at sinimulan ng dalawang magkaibigan ang kanilang European tour noong spring and summer ng 1887. Rizal and Viola arrived in Vienna from the Bohemian region, now the Czech Republic, on a Friday afternoon in spring, on board a train called Nordbahn. The two Filipino visitors caused quite a stir, with a local newspaper reporting of their presence and referring to Rizal as the best poet of his people. Vienna, founded in the first century by the Romans, had recently undergone a massive facelift by 1887. Most of the now well-known sites in Vienna, such as the Vienna State Opera, the Saxe Hotel, the Rathaus, or City Hall, and the Austrian Parliament, were only a few years old by the time of Rizal and Viola's visit.
The famous Natural History Museum, the Art History Museum, and the Neuburg, or the new wing of the Hofburg Palace, were merely construction sites then.
The Austrian Emperor at that time, Franz Joseph, husband of Empress Sisi, dreamed of a more modern city. So, what would a Kaiser and King do? He built the city of his dreams from the ground up. He leveled the city's medieval fortifications and built the Ringstrasse. This was the Vienna that Rizal and Viola explored. Pagkadating sa Vienna noong May 20, 1887, ng alas 12:30 ng hapon, nagpadala agad ng postcard si Rizal kay Blumentritt na nakarating na sila sa nasabing siyudad at naka-check-in sila sa Hotel Metropole. At that time, Hotel Metropole was considered one of the most elegant addresses in town. Yet, the once glamorous Hotel Metropole later became notorious as the headquarters of the Gestapo. The original building did not survive the ravages of World War II.
Still, this location carries meaning for Filipinos. On the 134th anniversary of Rizal's birth, the National Historical Commission of the Philippines and the Municipal Council of Vienna unveiled this historical marker on the building where the old Hotel Metropole once stood to commemorate Rizal's stay in Austria.
Remains to this day the only Rizal-related marker in the city of Vienna. Vienna, by modern standards, is a compact city. Everything is within walking distance in the inner district.
Be mindful of the cobblestones and wear comfortable shoes. But may sarili-sarili rin tayong definition ng komportable. Also located inside the Ringstrasse is Vienna's oldest restaurant, which was established in 1447, Griechenbeisel. hindi pa dumadating si Magellan sa Pilipinas, nakatayo na yan. Given the novelty of eating in a 440-year-old restaurant, Rizal and Viola might have at least been tempted to have one of their meals here. We can only guess about their Viennese foodie adventures. However, we can confirm that Rizal and Viola indulge in a visit to the map. Though at that time, it was known as the Museum of Art and Industry. Dala ang recommendation letter ni Blumenthal na kilala nila sa museum ito si Johannes Nordman, isang writer and journalist who worked at this museum.
Ikinuwento ni Rizal na nilibot sila ni Nordman sa buong museo. Their visit also coincided with an ongoing exhibit on religious artifacts from the early Middle Ages to the present, as in 1887. Nais pa sana nilang magtagal sa museo kung hindi lamang inabutan ng gutom si Viola. Napakaganda ang impresyon ni Rizal kay Nordman na nilarawan niyang kapareho ng kanyang ama, si Francisco Mercado, sa pagiging marangal, mabait, at iba pang mabuting ugali. Nakilala din nila ang asawa at anak ni Nordman na nagtungo rin sa museo.
So, what else could they have seen in Vienna?
As we all know, Rizal was a man of learning. Close to the Mac, we find the old university corridor of Vienna that used to house the first location of the University of Vienna, considered as the third oldest university in Central Europe. It was built in 1365. Mas matanda pa sa restaurant. The university was built adjacent to the city's Jesuit church. Rizal would have been interested in this, considering his Jesuit education at the Ateneo Municipal. It's easy to imagine Rizal and Viola wandering through the cobblestone streets, admiring elegant stores and houses. Iniikot ni Rizal ang iba't ibang bookshops sa siyudad na ito. Sa katunayan, Agosto 1886 pa lamang ay binanggit na ni Rizal kay Blumentritt na nais nitong magtungo sa Vienna upang bumili ng full library. Then and now, this area of stores and houses easily connected to the heart of the inner city. Here, they would have seen the St. Stephen's Cathedral or Stephansdom.
A building that emanates such grandeur would have been hard to miss.
At this moment in time, Vienna was mesmerized by the musical genius of Johann Strauss, the son, the famous composer of the Danube Waltz, or the Blue Danube. Pinigyan ni Nordman si Rizal at Viola ng tickets para manood ng teatro. A night in the Vienna State Opera would have been a likely choice for the duo. Bukod sa kagandahan ng siyudad, ay hindi rin lumagpas sa paningin ng binatang Rizal ang kagandahan ng mga kababaihan sa siyudad na ito. Ayon kay Viola, nagkaroon ng isang romantic adventure si Rizal sa isang Viennese lady na inilarawan niyang may pambihira at kakabighaning kagandahan.
Vienna was and still is a great city for music and even romance. What is a trip to Vienna without some classical music or a waltz or two?
Vienna's cafe scene was also flourishing in 1887. The popular cafes of today, Café de Mel of the Sacher Throat fame, Café Central, Café Landmann, and Café Schwarzenberg were already welcoming customers during Rizal and Viola's visit.
The city's intellectual and cultural elites, including the psychologist Sigmund Freud,
were regulars in these coffee houses. Dr. Freud, how's your coffee?
Viennese cosmopolitan culture made enough of an impression on Rizal that he referred to Viennese cafes in his second novel, El Filibusterismo.
Nordman, aware of Rizal's involvement in the propaganda movement, introduced him and Viola to the members of the Austrian press club, Concordia, whose main headquarters was situated here.
Nakilala din si Rizal ng ilang mga periodista ng siyudad. Kinuwento niyang nilapitan siya ng isang nangangalang Mr. Adler ng periodikong Extra Blatt upang humingi ng isang interview. Pinag-usapan nila sa interview ang kalagayan ng Pilipinas at sabi ni Rizal, bagaman hindi siya sanay sa mga panayam, ay magaan naman ang kanyang kalooban dahil binahagi lamang niya kung ano ang totoong kalagayan ng bayan.
After approximately 4 days in Vienna,
the two travelers boarded a boat on the Great Danube that took them upstream to the next destination in their grand European tour, the city of Linz. Kinuwento ni Viola na habang nasa barko, namangha si Rizal sa ganda ng Danube River. From Linz, they boarded a train to their last stop in the Austro-Hungarian Empire, Salzburg. Halos isang buwan matapos ang kanilang paglalakbay sa Vienna, sumulat si Rizal noong June 6, 1887 kay Blumentritt tungkol sa magaganda nilang karanasan sa nasabing pagbisita. While Rizal only stayed in Vienna for 4 days, he came back sa inang bayan with what we can only surmise to be a greater understanding of the world and hope for the Filipino people. No matter how far he traveled, Rizal remained faithful to his homeland and its promise. So should you find yourself in Vienna, imagine the city through Rizal and Viola's eyes.
Indulge in the sights and sounds of the city that connects the old and new alike. Hanggang sa muli! Ah, dito sa'yo.